Hello student, myself Harmeet, and today we are going to discuss the topic structure of atom. In your previous chapter, Dalton has told that the atom is indivisible or indestructible. That means it cannot be broken down into smaller particles. But with the discovery of two subatomic particles, it was found that yes, atom can be divided. So first of all, before moving ahead, we should know what are these two subatomic particles which we found. So the subatomic particles which were found or discovered by the scientists are electrons and protons. Before we go ahead that what is the structure of atom, we should know who discovered electron and who discovered proton. So, electron was discovered by J.J. Thomson, and proton was discovered by Rutherford. Remember these, what were the subatomic particles? Only electron and proton. But there is one more subatomic particle, that is neutron. Why I have not written electron and proton neutron here? Because electron and proton were the first discovered elements, and at that time scientists do not know that a neutron like particle also exists. So the only subatomic particles which were known to the scientists at that time was electrons and protons. Electrons was discovered by J.J. Thomson. Proton were discovered by Rutherford. Now when the scientists came to know that the atom can be divided and electrons or protons are present in it, they were curious to know about the structure of the atom. That how these electrons and protons are arranged in an atom. So there are many models which are describing the structure of atom, but we are going to discuss here the first ever model given by J.J. Thomson about the structure of atom. So let us start with the first model of structure of atom given by J.J. Thomson. Thomson said, consider your atom either as a watermelon or as a Christmas pudding. If you remember it in this way, you are never going to forget it. What was the atom given by Thomson? So, this is a cut watermelon or a Christmas pudding. In a watermelon, you see that most of the portion is red. So that red color is equivalent to the protons present in the atom. Whereas the seeds of the watermelon. Consider these seeds as the electrons which are present somewhere in this watermelon. So, Thomson gave two points first that the most portion of a structure of an atom is positively charged, that is the red portion of the watermelon. So most portion is what? Positively charged protons are present here, but whereas like the seeds of watermelon are present only somewhere, so though electrons are present only somewhere in the watermelon. The second point which he discussed is that he said that this model, this atom is